Warning. The following show may decrease your intelligence. Changing the channel is advised.
Zero variety. Less music. More talking. Weird noises. The show your parents warned you about. This is The Blair Radio Project.
Hello, and welcome to The Blair Radio Project. I'm your host, Blair, and I'm joined by none other than my trusty sound engineer, Billy. Billy, how are you doing today?
I'm good. How about you?
I'm great, Billy. Absolutely buzzing, like a little bumblebee on his way to go eat some delicious honey.
Bees don't actually eat honey.
Of course they do. They always eat honey. That's what they do.
No, it's not. They make honey.
Billy, bees don't make honey. Idiot.
Yeah, they do.
How? With pots and pans? I think not.
They throw it up.
What?
Honey is just bee vomit.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
All right. Well, I'm as happy as a bee that's about to throw up.
Oh, yeah? Why?
Because he ate too much honey. I don't know.
They don't eat honey. But no, that's not what I mean. I'm not asking, why is the bee going to throw up? I'm asking, why are you so happy?
Oh, I'm not, actually. I'm just pretending to be. I'm actually miserable, and I feel like I'm drowning and that I want to rip off my own face.
How would ripping off your face help if you were drowning?
It wouldn't, but that's just how I feel, okay? Desperate. Like grasping at straws.
Or face.
Yes, like grasping at face.
Why are you feeling miserable?
Because I'm here, and I don't want to be.
Then don't be here.
Billy, I'm an adult. I have responsibilities. I can't just call off work because I don't feel like coming in. People depend on me to come into work and record this show. I can't let all those people down.
Wow, I didn't know you took your job so seriously.
I do. And besides, I was about to call off work this morning, and then I remembered it's Taco Tuesday in the cafeteria. So that's really the only reason why I came in.
But we don't even have a cafeteria anymore. They sold it due to budget cuts.
Yeah, I know. But I forgot about it.
How could you forget that they sold the cafeteria? It's just a big empty room now.
It's technically not even a room either, since they sold off the walls as well.
Yeah, it is a bit weird to look at. Just a whole section of the building without a wall. Not to mention also how extremely unsafe it is. Doesn't even have a barrier or anything. And considering that it's up on the top floor, they could have at least put up some caution tape or something.
Well, they did put out one of those caution wet floor signs. I mean, it's kind of like caution tape. It's one of the major cautions. It's like the tape, but in floor sign form.
Well, it didn't do any good. I heard Peter fell out due to a strong gust of wind.
Yeah, I heard about that too. He must not have seen the sign.
The wind was so strong that it blew him out of the building and he fell in the car park.
Don't you mean the wind sucked him out?
What?
Well, if it blew him out, that means that the wind came from the inside of the building. Which is impossible because our aerodynamic testing fans are on the 6th floor, not the top floor.
But wind doesn't suck, it blows. So it blew him out.
Well, yeah, but because the cafeteria is on the top...
We don't have a cafeteria anymore.
Because it was on the top floor, the wind pressure is different, so that the wind would have had to... Forget it, I don't care. How's Peter anyway?
Luckily, a child down below broke his fall, so Peter's okay.
And how's the child?
They didn't make it.
Shame.
Indeed.
But you know what's not a shame, Billy?
What?
Music. So kicking things off, this is Edison Lighthouse with Love Grows, Where My Rosemary Goes. And you're listening to...
Blair Radio Project.
What's wrong?
It's these stupid socks.
What's wrong with your socks?
They don't match. Look.
Well, Blair, it looks like you're only wearing one.
No, I'm wearing two. You just can't see the other one.
Is it invisible?
No, it's not invisible, Billy. Idiot.
Well, I don't know.
Look, okay, I'm sorry for yelling at you. Look, have you heard of Mixed Match Monthly?
No. Is that a dating site or something?
No, I wish. It's a new sock subscription service where each week they mail out a set of mixed matched socks to you.
Each week?
Yeah.
But if it's each week, then why is it called Mixed Match Monthly?
I don't know, Billy. I didn't name it. That's besides the point. Look, each week, they mail out a pair of socks to you that are supposed to not match.
Okay.
At first, I thought that'd be cool. I'm like, oh, yeah. I like not wearing matching socks. I'm too lazy to match them. Fine. Cool. It'll be trendy in a way. Then the first pair came, and it was this sock with SpongeBob on it. Cool. I like that. But the sock that it came with was completely different.
Well, isn't that the point?
Well, yes, but look, see what I mean?
That's a baby sock.
Exactly, a baby sock.
Why would they send you a baby sock?
I don't know, I guess because it doesn't match.
But you'd think that if they're going to send you a pair of socks that don't match, it would just be two pairs of at least the same size.
You would think, Billy, wouldn't you? But no, they sent me this and a baby sock. So that was last week's socks. And then this week they sent me three socks.
Three socks?
Yeah, three. The first one is this unbelievably ugly tartan and polka dot design. I don't know what's going on here. And then they sent me a little kid's sock with Anne Frank on it.
Where's that?
Well, I'm wearing it on the other foot.
I don't see it.
Yeah, because it's a little kid's sock. It only goes halfway up my foot. Not just that. It completely stretches out the sock, so you can't even tell it's Anne Frank anymore. See? It looks like Yogi Bear.
Who?
Never mind.
What about the third sock?
The third sock is just this boring white sock, but it doesn't even have an opening to put your foot in. It's just a cloth bag.
Well, if you're unhappy with it, why don't you just cancel the service?
I can't. I already paid for the first full year. Up front.
How much did you pay?
I'd rather not say.
Well, hopefully you'll eventually get one pair that doesn't match. But at least the right size. And hey, if you ever have kids, which I doubt you ever will.
So do I.
At least you'll have baby socks.
You're listening to The Blair Radio Project. And now, with a wide variety of weird noises.
Hello, audience. Welcome back to the show. That was some music by some man.
Could have been a robot.
I stand corrected, audience. That was some music by what could have possibly have been a robot.
Are you feeling better?
Does it sound like I'm feeling better, Billy?
Well, you haven't mentioned death in about 5 minutes, so...
Exactly. I'm not myself. I'm tired. I'm bored. I'm cold. My socks are too small. Nothing's going right for me today. I wish I could just go back in time and tell myself to call off work so I could just stay in bed all day looking at my phone in a dimly lit room.
Well, what if I told you you still could?
What?
What if I told you that even though you're here, you could still have a chance not to be here?
What do you mean?
What if I told you that there's a way to undo being here?
Billy, this isn't some late night commercial, okay? Stop speaking in riddles and just tell me what you're trying to say.
You could always just travel back in time and tell yourself not to come into work.
Oh, all right. Well, it's really that simple, huh? Just time travel?
Yeah.
Billy, you idiots. Time travel doesn't exist.
How do you know?
Well, if it did, then I wouldn't be here right now. I would have already traveled back in time and told myself not to come into work. I'd be home, not sitting here wasting my time and breath talking to you.
Ah, but that's because you haven't made an effort to do it yet.
No, it's because it doesn't exist.
Well, there's this medium you could call. She's got a hotline.
A medium?
Yeah.
You mean like the thing in the middle of the street?
No, like a psychic. But a psychic medium, a real one. She also does time travel.
Billy, psychic mediums don't exist. They can't talk to spirits. They can't travel through time. And they can't do a third thing that would sound good here in my argument, okay? They're swindlers and con artists. They feed off people when they're most vulnerable and extort them for monies. I will never give a psychic medium any of my monies. Not a single penny.
You can use the station's credit card to call her.
What's her number?
It's time to lose your faith in humanity. It's the Blair Radio Project.
Though it hurts to go away,
How much long is this gonna take? We've been on hold for what feels like forever.
Blair, it's only been 5 minutes.
That's too long! Besides, I'm impatient, and I'm getting a really strong desire to suck on my phone.
Don't suck on the phone, Blair. Fight the urge.
Fine. What's this quack's name, anyway?
Madame Sylvia Gray. I hear she's really good.
Yeah? Where did you hear that?
On her commercial.
I suppose they wouldn't lie on her commercial then, huh?
Hello?
Hello?
What do you want?
Well, you tell me. You're the psychic, aren't you?
You're looking for your son?
I don't have a
son. Well, I see a lot of water. He's dead.
What?
The kid's dead. That'll be 500 pounds. Do you want me to talk to him? It'll be another 500 pounds.
No, I don't have a son. At least, not that I know of.
Not anymore.
No, I'm calling because I was told you could do time travel.
Yeah. What are you trying to do? Stop the assassination of John F. Kennedy?
No.
Prevent the horrific attacks of 9/11?
No. I just want to go back in time so that I can tell past me to not go into work. I want to pull a sickie for today.
That's it?
Well, yeah.
You don't want to prevent 9/11?
Well, I do, of course. But that's not what I'm calling about. I just want to sleep in and doom scroll on my phone all day.
So why didn't you call off work?
Because I thought it was Taco Tuesday in the cafeteria today, but it's not. We don't have a cafeteria anymore. We sold it.
Why did you sell your cafeteria?
Well, I didn't sell it. The station did. But it was due to budget cuts.
What station?
But that's not really important. The important part is there is no Taco Tuesday today.
Taco?
Yeah.
Taco as in the singer?
No, taco as in the crunchy Mexican food.
I see. So it's not Taco Tuesday?
No.
All right. Well, 700 pounds and consider it done. And because I like you, I'll even prevent the assassination of John F. Kennedy and the attacks of 9/11 for just 100 pounds.
All right, go on then.
Great.
I'm still here at work.
You gotta pay first, honey.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, just type in the card that you'd like to use into the phone.
Just type it in.
That's what I said, yes.
Wow, fancy.
Indeed.
This is some pretty exciting radio.
Shut up, Billy. All right, that's done.
Great. I'll call past you on the phone and tell you not to go into work, because there isn't going to be a Taco Tuesday.
Cool. All right, then.
All right, bye.
Well, I'm still here, Billy.
Give her a moment. You just got off the phone with her.
Good point. All right, fine. All right, audience, let's play another song, shall we? This is Tie a Yellow Ribbon Round the Old Oak Tree by Tony Orlando and Dawn. And you're listening to The Blair Radio Project. Hello, audience. Welcome back to the show.
Why do you always sound so aggressive?
I do not always sound aggressive. I'm upset. I didn't get a call from Sylvia. I never got one. I'm still here. I'm still here at work. I'm going to give her a call back and give her a piece of my mind.
All right. Well, while you do that...
It's that time again. It's the loop of the day.
It's that time again. It's the loop of the day. That's right, me. It's the loop. How do you do that, Blair?
It's a skill.
It's the loop of the day. Each week, we play a loop of a sample of a loop, and you gotta guess what song we are looping. This week's no exception, unfortunately. So here is this week's loop. Ooh, a tricky loop indeed, huh? Well, if you have any idea what this week's loop is, don't give us a call, because we're busy trying to call a scam artist.
Invented with the sole purpose of wasting your time. It's the Blair Radio Project.
It's our wedding day, I couldn't be more happy. We're a lark and I swallow.
Yes, Sylvia?
Speaking?
Yeah, this is Blair from earlier. I want a refund, and I want it now.
What are you talking about?
Earlier today, I called because I wanted you to time travel to tell past me not to come into work, because we're not having Taco Tuesday today. But obviously, you didn't do that, or else I wouldn't be here at work. Now would I? You told me I would get a call from you, and I never got one.
I called past you, but you didn't answer the phone. Do you sleep with the phone on silent or something?
Yes.
And how can I call you and tell you not to go into work if you don't answer the phone?
You could have left a voicemail.
That costs extra.
What?
If you want me to leave you a voicemail, it'll be another 700 pounds.
Another 700 pounds? You're a real piece of work, you know that? A real piece of work.
You can enter the card number when you're ready.
Okay.
Playing the very best commercials with great music in between. You're listening to The Blair Radio Project.
Hello, Blair here. Say, how would you like to win a chance to hang out with me? Well, you can't. But you can follow me on both Instagram and X. That's basically the same thing. Just don't message me. I hardly ever post anything. And when I do, it's low effort memes and not much else. But if this somehow interests you, you can follow me on Instagram at cd.punk or on X at cd_punk. You can't follow me on both, though. If I notice that you followed me on both, I will block you. Thank you.
As long as I pose, I don't care if you're next to me. Pose one.
Hello, audience. Welcome back to the show. What are you doing on your phone, Blair? Are you playing Candy Crush?
No, I'm not playing Candy Crush. I'm checking my voicemails to see if Sylvia called me this morning when I was sleeping.
Did she?
I don't think so. I always have a bunch of missed calls, but they're all from my bank.
What about voicemails? Do you have any voicemails?
Only ones from my bank.
What do they say?
The usual. You owe us this. We'll repossess that. Blah, blah, blah. Just the same empty threats they've been spouting for years.
I see.
But no, not a single voicemail or call is from Sylvia.
Madam Sylvia.
Whatever. I'm gonna call her back.
Look, Blair, maybe you are right.
About Louis Capaldi being overrated?
Yes, but not that. About her being a con artist. Having a front row seat to watching her scam you has opened my eyes and made me realize this truly is a bunch of garbage.
I told you it was, Billy. I know. So that's exactly why I'm going to call her back and demand a full refund back onto my card.
You mean the station's card?
No, my card.
But you didn't pay for any of this. The station did. You used the station's credit card, remember?
The station's card, my card. It doesn't matter. It's the principle that matters, Billy.
Right, but if the station paid for it, surely it's that card that should be getting the refund put onto it, right?
Look, Billy, I don't know. Don't make me think more than I have to, okay? Whichever card is easier for her to refund, that's the card I'll use, okay? And if it just so happens to be one that has my name on it, then so be it.
Whatever.
It's that time again. It's the loop of the day.
Earlier on, we played this loop. Hey, Mappa! Hey, Mappa! Hey, Mappa! Hey, Mappa! Hey, Mappa! Hey, Mappa! Now for the big reveal to this week's loop. Hey, Mappa, hey, Mappa, hey, Mappa, hey, Mappa. Oh, Dad, I'm out here getting loose. Gotta blame it on a goose. Gotta blame it on my juice, baby. Hey, Mappa, oh, Dad, I'm out here making news. Time to put it in the proof. Gotta blame it on my juice. Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's right, ladies and jelly beans. This week's loop was none other than Juice by Lizzo.
Hey, Billy.
What?
Do you think any jelly beans actually listen to the show?
No. Did you get it right? Did you get it wrong? Did you even bother to participate? Probably not.
Billy?
What?
shut up and play the next song.
Okay.
Sylvia?
Speaking.
This is Blair. Look, I didn't get any calls from you this morning, nor did I get a voicemail, so I want a full refund put onto my card now. And also, just so you know, the card that will be receiving a refund isn't a different name than the card that was used for the first two transactions. Okay?
But I did call you again, and I didn't even have to leave a voicemail this time.
What?
You picked up the phone. I told you that it wasn't Taco Tuesday, and that you should call off work and stay in bed instead. And guess what? Past you is laying in bed right now.
But it's not possible. I'm still here.
You're still there, but they're not.
What do you mean?
That's because that was a different you. The you I called is in another dimension, not the you in this dimension.
You called a different me?
Yes, one in a different dimension. And guess what? The other dimension you is super happy. They're in bed, laying in their own filth, and just staring at their phone. They couldn't be happier.
That jerk! But Sylvia, I didn't want you to call other dimension me. I wanted you to call this dimension me. Mimi!
Oh, well, why didn't you say?
Because I didn't know that calling the other dimensional me was possible.
It's not.
How about this? I'll give you a special offer, okay? It's one time only. I'll call this dimension you and tell you not to come into work. And I'll do that for only half the price, okay? Only 350 pounds. How does that sound?
You'll call past me, me?
Past you, you.
You're listening to The Blair Radio Project. Your radio just got a whole lot sexier.
You bet your kneecaps it did.
My kneecaps?
Yes, your kneecaps.
Slip into something a little more comfortable. You're listening to The Blair Radio Project.
Hello, audience. Hello, welcome back to the show. I want to thank you all so much for listening to the show this week. Well, you probably listened from the comfort of your own home while I slaved away here at work. Taco-less.
I take it she didn't call you.
No, of course she didn't call me, Billy. Because it was a scam. And what's worse is that she blocked my number, so I can't even get a refund now.
Or get scammed for a fourth time.
Well, Billy, I guess you were right about me being right. This whole psychic medium hocus-pocus thing is just a bunch of junk.
Yep.
Psychics and mediums, they can't talk to the dead. They can't predict the future. They can't time travel. They can't prevent 9/11. They can't do any of it. It's all just a big scam.
What's 9/11?
You know, 9/11, September the 11th. The attack on the World Trade Center, the Pentagon, that field.
9/11?
Yeah.
9/11. Oh, you mean that time John F. Kennedy single-handedly prevented those plane hijackings?
He did what?